Hello. This is the 19th in the series, History of Early Jazz. And today we go to Kansas City, where we hear perhaps the most popular band of all time, the Coon Sanders Original Nighthawks. Coon Sanders' band consisted of Carlton Coon on drums and pianist Joe Sanders, as they led, or co-led, one of the most amazing bands in the history of jazz. Let's start right in by hearing vocal by Joe Sanders, "Here Comes My Ball and Chain." Dynamic. This was a group, Coon Sanders' Original Nighthawks, which recorded from 1924 to 1932. And today there is a Coon Sanders Appreciation Society, and they meet every year, and the band hasn't made a record since 1932 when Carlton Coon died. Truly an amazing feat. And it just gives you a measure, an indication of how much people remember and love this band. They made 84 sides for RCA Victor and two, or rather one, for Columbia when they first started out. Then they switched to Victor, and 84 sides is all that remains from this great band, and we're going to be surveying some of their better selections better. It's really a question not of choosing better sides, but any side at all, because arranger Joe Sanders, the pianist, was among the first to spread saxophone section voicing. He inserted a vocal into almost every selection, and every instrument was given a chance to be heard. Joe Sanders and Carlton Coon met one day beside a piano in a Kansas City, Missouri music store at the end of World War I. And that meeting, from that meeting, came the Coon Sanders partnership dance band. They were called the Nighthawks because they broadcast from midnight to 2 every night from Kansas City's Muehlbach Hotel over WDAF. How'd you do, you big old radio public, was the familiar cheery greeting of the old left-hander, Master Showman Joe Sanders, as the Nighthawks took the air in those pioneering days when Coon Sanders was the first organized band ever to play for radio. A saucer-sized microphone hung before the bandstand, and when Cooney and Joe mellifluously blended voices, they sent in chanting harmonies micward with the aid of hand megaphones. So many telegraph requests came from coast-to-coast listeners, all craving identification with the Nighthawks' sleepless fraternity, their Knights and Ladies of the Bath late Saturday program that Western Union installed a ticker tape between the piano and drums so that Joe and Cooney could literally acknowledge dozens of wires with each air session. Let's listen to one of their fabulous arrangements, Red Hot Mama. Great. Red Hot Mama by Coon Sanders' Nighthawks. From 1918 to 1932, the personnel of the 9 or 10 piece Nighthawks band varied only slightly. Some of the men comprising the group were Tom Beckham on banjo, Nick Mussolina trombone, Pop Estep tuba, Happy Williams banjo, Orville Knapp saxophone, Joe Rickelson and Bob Pope trumpets, and it's Bob Pope's trumpet that we're going to be hearing next. What a phenomenal player. Crystal clear, beautiful sound. Rex Downing, trombone, Elmer Krebs, tuba, John and Harold Thiel, saxophones, Bill Hayden, Russ Stout, banjos, Floyd Estep, saxophone, Carlton Coon, drums and vocal, Joe Sanders, piano and vocal, and we'll both hear Coon and Sanders doing their vocaling on I Ain't Got Nobody. Coming into Chicago in 1924, the Nighthawks scored so well in initial engagements at the Lincoln Tavern and at the Congress Hotel that when the Music Corporation of America booking agency promised the Black Hawk Restaurant a top-flight band for its 1926 venture into musical entertainment, Coon Sanders received the nod. Via nightly broadcast over WGN, the Chicago Tribune station, where an hour was often shared with the Ted Weems and Wayne King orchestras, Nighthawk popularity soared to unprecedented heights, and the Victor waxings by Coon Sanders were much coveted. Let's listen now to Some of These Days, arranged beautifully and most imaginatively by Joe Sanders. Thank you. How exciting. What a magnificent sound. Here we go with Joe Sanders, born in Thayer, Kansas on October 15th, 1896, the son of a hard luck cattle rancher and citrus fruit grower. Joe spent his boyhood in Indian Territory, known today as Centralia, Missouri. At 10, he was a boy soprano, later a concert pianist and high baritone soloist with the Kansas City Oratorio Society and member of a male quartet. Near the close of his World War I Army service, Sanders chanced to meet Carlton Coon, and the Nighthawks were born. A superb vocalist, showman, and master of the keyboard, Joe Sanders needed no microphone to lean on. Rather, he held a small mic in his right hand while tinkling the ivories with his left. His excellent diction, choice of words, and ready wit helped make him a radio favorite. Let's listen now to one of their great recordings, thanks in great measure to Joe Sanders, who not only arranged this but plays a magnificent piano solo. Darktown Strutters Ball vocalist Carlton Coon. Phenomenal recording of the 1917 favorite Darktown Strutters Ball, recorded by Coon Sanders' original Nighthawks on December 12, 1929. You notice how they feature Pop F-Step on the tuba, and you can not only hear him, but he has a chance to solo and then blend in, giving the band that nice, solid, deep sound. Rocking it all the way, instead of Coon's drumming, we have F-Step's tuba sort of pushing the band along. And with the saxophone section voicing, very, very important, because While Fletcher Henderson did that, as we'll hear in a future show, in 1923, the voicings used by Joe Sanders for the Coon Sanders Nighthawks is something special. He's achieving different effects with his normal instrumentation of the time. But it's these special effects that make the Coon Sanders Band outstanding. Let's listen to a pop tune of the 1926 era, which was extremely popular then, but never became a standard, as Darktown Strutters Ball has. This one's called I'm Gonna Charleston Back to Charleston. Coon, or Cooney, was born in Rochester, Minnesota on February 5, 1894. After the Coon family had moved to Lexington, Missouri, youthful Cooney enjoyed going down to the Missouri riverbank to both sing and shoot dice with Negro dock workers, a happy lot with whom Carlton not only improved his ability to harmonize, but from whom he picked up musical ideas for future use, beginning with a high school dance combo he conducted before the days of the Nighthawks. Joe Sanders not only was the great arranger for the band and pianist and high tenor, but he also composed some pieces for the band, including this one, High Fever, recorded in 1926. Thank you. while they were in Chicago, they traded tunes with the Doc Cook Dreamland Orchestra, and this was one of them. High Fever. We'll be listening to Doc Cook and his Dreamland Orchestra because of his superb cornetist Freddie Keppard in a later show, and we'll hear the difference between the Coon Sanders High Fever and Doc Cook's High Fever. What a neat instrumental that was. What great precision. What great feeling. We'd like to play now a tune illustrating that great feeling with a very, very popular tune. Yes, Sir, That's My Baby. Magnificent. We've had so many fast foxtrots that it's time now to hear the band in a ballad. What a beautiful ballad it is, a tune that never outlasted the 20s, with a vocal by Joe Sanders, Alone at Last. Thank you. absolutely beautiful ballad, Alone at Last, one of the very, very beautiful numbers of the 20s. Contrasting that with one of the snappy numbers of the 20s, Everything is Hotsy-Totsy Now. Everything is Hotsy-Totsy Now with the Coon Sanders original Nighthawks. What a phenomenal sound. And because they could offer every kind of mood, in Chicago, both vocalists Joe Sanders and Carlton Coon do the old Sophie Tucker favorite, After You've Gone.
Thank you. dearest little pal you ever had. Cause there'll come a time, now don't forget it, there'll come a time when you'll regret it. Someday when you grow lonely, your heart will break like mine. You want me only after you've gone, after you've gone away.
Pop Epstep tuba solo and Rex Downing on trombone, featuring really the whole band on that one. What a magnificent arrangement. You never would have guessed that was a 1917 pop tune from its very, very classy and up-to-date 1929 arrangement by Joe Sanders. After You've Gone. I mentioned earlier, and we heard one of Joe Sanders' original compositions. It's time for another one. This is a fabulous number that nobody else managed to record except, of course, Doc Cook's Dreamland Orchestra, who recorded quite a few of the Coon Sanders originals, and I wonder why. Of course, one of the Doc Cook originals, Here Comes My Hot Tamale Man, was also recorded by Coon Sanders' Nighthawks, except it wasn't released. There had to be some kind of a tie-in. They were two very strong bands with two very strong pianist arrangers. Anyway, let's listen to Brainstorm, the Joe Sanders original, one of their rare instrumental numbers. So terribly late, of course, because they only recorded until 1932, when Carlton Coon, the drummer, died. This is a tune that was very popular in the 20s, but somehow didn't seem to have any lasting qualities beyond its own time. It's called Is She My Girlfriend, featuring that great organization, the Coon Sanders Nighthawks. Nice. Everybody gets a chance to show off with the Coon Sanders Nighthawks because of Joe Sanders' fabulous arrangements. There has never been a band quite like the Coon Sanders sound, and there probably won't be. One of the Joe Sanders' marvelous compositions to show off the good humor of the band, with vocal by both Joe Sanders and Carlton Coon, Slewfoot. Thank you.
a flower. Ease him down, strut some more. Sweet little lay him low, like you know how to do. Glue him down to the spot. No, baby, get hot. Slew-foot, don't you hear that song? Two-foot, move your feet along. Blue-foot, oh, it won't be long. Slew-foot, don't you do me wrong. Shake him up on me.
Joe Sanders died in 1965, but Carlton Coon was only 38 at the time of his death on May 4, 1932. A good-looking drummer was suffering from a jaw abscess when he died at Chicago's Henroten Memorial Hospital, while the Nighthawk Band was endeavoring to carry on in his absence at Hotel Sherman's College Inn. Without this jolly chap sitting up front behind the drums, ready to blend his mellow voice with that of Sanders, or slip in a cheery greeting to some far-off shut-in radio friend, things just couldn't be the same. Although riding the crest of a national popularity wave and seemingly destined to remain there for many years, the Coon Sanders Orchestra disbanded. Let's hear them in a Joe Sanders original called Blazin'.
Thank you.